Hand injuries are commonly seen in the emergency department, and proper evaluation and treatment of these complaints can be limb-saving. Injuries often involve the tendons, nerves, bones, blood vessels, and skin of the hand. When obtaining a history from the patient, it's important to note the patient's age, hand dominance, occupation, tetanus status, the mechanism, and the time course of the injury. These factors are important in risk stratifying the patient. For example, an injury which occurred due to a dog bite places the patient for high risk of Pasteurella multocyta infection, or likewise, Eichenella corrodens infection from a human bite. In open fractures, the time elapsed since injury is important to know in order to minimize injury from vascular loss and for wound management. When examining the hand, it's important to assess the patient in steps. 1. Appearance. Check for finger position with respect to scissoring or flexing at rest, gross deformity, such as an open fracture or dislocation, and bruising or swelling. 2. Vascular status. Check by assessing radial and ulnar pulses and capillary refill, which should be less than 2 to 3 seconds. 3. Sensation and motor function. For motor function, check the following. First, the median nerve, also known as the tea drinking nerve. Test by checking the OK sign. Ask the patient to touch the tip of the index finger to the tip of the thumb. Second, the ulnar nerve, looking at intrinsic muscle function. Test by asking the patient to hold a piece of paper between adducted fingers as you try to pull it away. Finally, the radial nerve, looking at extensor muscle function. Test by asking the patient to give a thumbs up and to twist their wrist. For sensory function, check the patient's sensation in the distribution of the median, ulnar, and radial nerves.